In this video, I'm going to talk about database field constraints. This is an advanced feature of the software, and in order to use it, you will need to be signed in as the administrator. So first of all, let's take a look at what constraints are already in the system. So let's look at the customers table, for example. Let's click on New and create a new customer. And then just try and save after just typing in the name. You'll notice that you've got four warnings that come up because you've left certain fields blank. It will let you ignore the warnings and carry on and save this customer, or you can go back to the form and fill in the blank fields that are required. So let's now show how to add your own field constraints. By doing this, you're essentially customizing the behavior of the program. So let's go up to the toolbar in Admin and Database Field Constraints. We need to create a new one, so select New on your toolbar. And we're working in the Customers table, so we can select Customers, but you will see below there are many different tables that we can choose from. So as we're using Customers, let's select that. And then the field. For example, we're going to put in that we need their SIN number filled in. So we also might not want it to read SIN number, so we can also change the field name. So let's change that to social insurance number. And we are not going to select mandatory. I will show you another example with the mandatory button, but for now, this will be optional. So save, and then go back to your customers. Let's select that new customer again. And go down, try and click save. And you'll see that your new constraint has been added. So you forgot to enter your social insurance number. Again, we didn't select mandatory, so we could ignore all these warnings and still continue and save this customer and just still have it as a warning if you want your end users to just be aware that they need to fill that in. So let's just go back to the form. And now let's go and add another constraint. This time I'm going to show you a mandatory constraint. So select New, and again we are in the Customers table. And in this field, let's say that the country is mandatory. So country, select the button mandatory and save. We'll go back to our Customers entry. Now, your system will automatically fill in the country name, so we're going to actually manually delete this. And let's try and save. You'll notice that your warning has come up, country cannot be left blank. Because this is mandatory, it is showing you that by itself, because you cannot continue until you fill this in. So we'll say OK. We'll fill this in. Now when we click save, you'll see that your optional constraints have now been come through. So again, the social insurance number is the one we added, and the rest were already in the system. So let's just ignore these warnings, and we save the customer. One thing I'd like to mention is that if you are upgrading your software at any point, the constraints that you have added personally will still remain even in your upgraded software.